Y'all may be seated. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer. God, today we ask that your spirit be in this place. Father, as these two are ready to be joined in holy matrimony, that you are blessing them, you will bless them for the rest of their lives. And as we gather together, as they grow closer to each other while growing closer to God, we thank you for this day. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Who gives the bride in marriage?
Her mother and I do.
Oh.
Let's step up.
Okay.
Don't fit.
It is an honor today for me to perform this ceremony because about 2 months before I retired as pastor, Blake came to me and asked me to baptize him. And so when he called me and said, "Would you do my ceremony?" it meant so much to me that I made a little bit of an impact on him that he would call me and want me to do this. I have chosen some verses today from Romans chapter 12, starting in verse 9, and they go like this. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourself. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fever serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Patient hospitality. We see several things in these verses that has a lot to do with marriage. The first thing I see is love must be sincere by honoring each other. I've heard it said that marriage is 50-50. But from experience, and I believe what God wants us to do, is give 110 each way. There'll be days, Rachel, when you'll have to give 110% of your love to him to help him to survive in this world. Likewise, there'll be days where you'll have to give 110% to Rachel for her to make it through the day. Marriage isn't something you find, it is something you make, and the key ingredients is sincere love. Be devoted to each other in love. Second thing I pulled out of this was keep your spirituality strong by serving the Lord. Now, you know, as a pastor, I challenge people to not just go to church, but be the church. And when you do this, it will help your spirituality grow even stronger each day. Because when you're in church, you're sharing with believers. And believers, we have problems. There's going to be rough roads. There's going to be potholes. There's going to be gravel roads that we sling gravel. But when you go to the Lord and you grow, it will make it easier. We all have a purpose. And your purpose now has changed. You were single, having fun, full of life. But now your purpose is unity. Because the Bible tells us that when a man leaves his father and mother and comes to a wife, they become one. I pray that y'all become one, working together for the glory of God. The last thing I see is praying together. In Ephesians 4:26, it says this, "In your anger, do not sin. Do not let the sun go down while you are still angry." In times of disagreement, go to the Lord in prayer. When you ask Him to intervene, He will show you and draw you back together. I've told you all this in Ecclesiastes about the three strands. When you put God in the center of this marriage, nothing Satan can do can pull it away. Stay strong in your faith. Stay strong in your church. And Satan can't do anything about it. We're going to exchange vows now. Blake, repeat after me. I, Blake, promise to love and to cherish Rachel.
I, Blake, promise to love and cherish Rachel.
To honor and sustain her.
To honor and sustain her.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In poverty as in wealth.
In poverty as in wealth.
In the bad that may darken our days.
In the bad that may darken our days.
In the good that may brighten our ways.
In the good that may brighten our ways.
And to be true to her until death alone shall part us.
And to be true to her until death alone shall apart us.
Rachel, would you repeat after me? I, Rachel, promise to love and cherish Blake.
I, Rachel, promise to love and cherish Blake.
To sustain him.
To sustain him.
In sickness as in health.
In sickness as in health.
In poverty as in wealth.
In poverty as in wealth.
In the bad that may darken our days.
In the bad that may darken
our days. In the good that may brighten our ways.
In the good that may brighten our ways.
And to be true to him until death.
And to be true to him until death.
Death alone shall part us.
Death alone shall part us.
Now we're going to do the ring ceremony. And our ring bearer is bringing him over.
Let me do this often.
Good boy.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Can you put that back on, please?
He wants to stay right here.
Yeah, he does.
Open it later. All right. This one goes first, doesn't it?
Yes, sir.
Blake, if you'll place this ring on Rachel's finger. The ring is a symbol of two things. A precious gold that God loves and an unending circle of a marriage that will not end. I want you to repeat after me, Blake. Would you hold her hand? Make it look like you love her. I give this ring.
I give this ring.
As a token of my eternal love and commitment.
As a token of my eternal love and commitment.
To live with you in Christian marriage.
To live with you in Christian marriage.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Rachel. Place a ring on his finger and repeat after me. I give this ring.
I give this ring.
As a token of my eternal love and commitment.
As a token of my eternal love and commitment.
To live with you in Christian marriage.
To live with you in Christian marriage.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Blake, Rachel, I have heard your pledge with love and faith to each other. Your friends and family have heard your seal of vows and giving and receiving of rings. It is my joy and personal privilege to declare you husband and wife. Guess what? You may kiss the bride. Watch it. Lord, we just thank you for this day. Father, we ask for blessings upon this marriage. I pray that nothing Satan can do can ever break it apart. Father, I know these two, and I've grown to see how their love for each other is so strong. And I pray that it gets stronger each day as their love for you gets stronger each day. Father, we love you and we give you the praise and the glory that you deserve. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You may face the crowd. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Blake Savage. Yeah.
I wish I could. Yeah.
I know, that was really fast. Didn't have time to cry. Almost, Rachel.
What?
Almost crying.
You almost cried?
Almost. Oh, it started dwelling.
I did.
It started dwelling. And then I was like, I have to cry? I'm gonna have to cry. You're next.
My legs were shaking, Rachel. I felt like the blood was dripping out of me.
Rachel was shaking.
I was so scared.
I'm shaking a little bit too. Just not anymore.
Ma'am.
Yeah, looks so pretty. They weren't lying. They were like, she looks so beautiful. That was really fast.
That was so fast. Well, congratulations.
Ruben.
No way.
Barry, he's behind you. Thank you. Great job, Tyler.
Was it good?
Yeah, you did great.
So handsome, congratulations.
Thank you. Rachel.
Congratulations.
Am I supposed to hold on to this thing?
Sure. That was so fast.
Thank you.
Megan says she's sorry
she couldn't make it. When you came down the aisle, I was like, Taylor, that's so cute. I can't believe you're married on me.
Oh.
Yeah, what a hug girl we get
making.
I wanted to cry.
Yeah.
That's a love.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Oh, my God. Of course. I had to invite y'all. Of course. I was really glad to see you here.
Yeah, that's nice.
Scooby did a great job, dude.
You did
a great job, too, Nathan.